Welcome back, you guys. I'm Funky Like Feathers, and today we're going to be talking about NaNoWriMo 2020. Things I've learned from past years, how I'm going to make this year different, if I'm going to make this year different, projects, all that jazz. So let's get into it. My mug for today, I actually got because one of my neighbors gave it to me. Isn't it cool? It's clear. It's all see-through. I like it. It's kind of fun. So this year is 2020. That is kind of like a euphemism for dumpster fire. This year's NaNoWriMo is going to be vastly different than past years. I've learned a lot from the past years that I've done NaNoWriMo, and this year is very different than previous years for other reasons too. I happen to also be the ML for a brand new region north of Houston. We are the Conroe and Spring region. I'm very excited. Yay! I have a region completely brand new. You know, I've got a lot of writers that I know from previous years. However, we really weren't, you know, like involved in the Houston area because Houston is huge. So now we have our own region. I'm super duper excited. But that also means that I have to do all this stuff on my own. Being an ML for an entire region is not the easiest thing in the world. I'm very, very grateful to the helpers that I have with me who, you know, don't necessarily want to be official co-MLs. Susanna and Maria, I totally see you. I could not do this without them. I am so, so grateful. Now this year, what, you know, also makes that different is the fact that we cannot meet in person this year. There are no official in-person NaNoWriMo meetups this year, which is insane because in previous years, that's kind of like the number one thing that keeps people going is actually showing up to events. So everything has to be virtual, which is frustrating, don't get me wrong, but at the same time, I mean, I get it. Especially for people who are immunocompromised, I totally understand this, you know, and we don't want NaNoWriMo to be the reason for anyone's health declining. So I definitely want you guys to stay healthy, stay, you know, proactive for your own health out there. Make sure that you're staying connected with others as well, because like seriously, we all need to. Now, what else makes this year very different for NaNoWriMo is the fact that I am being a NaNoWriMo rebel. Is anyone really surprised? Because I'm not actually going to be writing a brand new novel. I'm going to be focusing on the first novel that I wrote for NaNoWriMo, and I'm gonna get this thing stinking done. I need to finish editing it. It is a whopping like 71,000 words, but it needs to be properly edited. I have kind of like picked it up, put it back down, picked it up, put it back down, worked on other people's projects, the whole ordeal, but I just need to finish this thing. So, you know, if you're the same way, let me know down in the comments. Hit the like button if you're kind of a procrastinator when it comes to finishing, because yeah, I am. I mean, like for the most part, in most other aspects of life, like I get stuff done, but when it comes to finishing this massive project I decided to create myself, I have not actually gotten it done. So this is the month that it's going to happen. Let me know what your projects are down in the comments. I wanna know, are you guys writing a brand new book this year? Are you editing? Are you working on poems? Like, what is it that everybody's doing this year? I seriously want to know. I mean, we've got tons of stuff in the process. You know, like I said, no worries. We've got you covered for virtual events and everything. That is one thing that I do absolutely love is virtual write-ins, because there's tons of them online on YouTube. We've got people who, you know, all over the world do virtual live write-ins. We're gonna be doing live discussions with a different speaker every single week. So I'm very excited about that too, covering like different topics. And actually even tonight, I mean, I don't know if this video is gonna go out in time, but tonight I'm actually talking to Meredith E. Phillips specifically about drafting. So if you have not checked her out, I will put a link to her channel down in the description box below as well, because she's got some awesome videos for NaNoWriMo and writing in general, of course. So she's here on YouTube as well, and you need to check her out. Have you loaded up on coffee? How are you preparing for NaNo? We're gonna talk about that too, what I am doing to prepare for NaNo differently this year as opposed to most years. So I will come to you guys in another video to talk about that. Let me know what it is that you've got going on down in the comments below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.